Everyone, welcome to this week's Dennis Kirk Tech Tip. And this week I'm going to show you how to replace the hydraulic brake fluid in your Kawasaki KX450. The same technique actually applies to all dirt bikes. I've gotten good at it on the Cowie because a few years ago Kawasaki outfitted the bike with an oversized rear rotor. And not so much on practice days, but on race days, maybe it's nerves or something, but I always tend to drag the rear brake a little bit and kind of cook the fluid. And I used to have to come in from practice and bleed the whole system. Replacing your brake fluid is something you should probably do every couple months regardless, as obviously brakes are a very important part of riding motocross and off-road. And the fluid does get hot and wear out and lose its effectiveness. So we're gonna replace the fluid with Maxima racing brake fluid, which you've had great luck with. So the tools needed for this job are, first and foremost, a bottle of brand new brake fluid. We rely on Maxima racing brake fluid. Have had great success with all Maxima products. Maxima, of course, is stocked by Dennis Kirk. So we have that bottle of that, empty water bottle. You'll need a section of fuel hose. You can use the one straight off your bike, off the fuel cap, that works. A couple zip ties or duct tape, a 6mm wrench, and a 10mm wrench. So while the traditional method is pump open with the bleeder valve, if you create a little curly Q here, you can just pump straight through. So you take your fuel line and zip tie it in a circle. You could also use, obviously, duct tape, or if you're a serious mechanic, you could have something like this full time in your toolbox. In this instance, I just used the fuel line off of our bike itself. And before we put it back on the bike, shoot some contact cleaner through it. So just like that, simple and easy, keeps the air from going back in when you're bleeding. So you're gonna wanna remove your master cylinder cover. That's where the 6mm wrench comes into play. And I always like to keep a rag handy because brake fluid is some nasty stuff. Once you break them loose, I always just use my fingers to take them out. So beneath the cap, there's a bladder. And make sure that stays on the cap. Actually, the Kawasaki is, it's not shaped symmetrically, so there's only one way it can go on. Okay, so this is the bleeder valve for the rear disc, the rear caliper. 10mm right there. So what I do is you fit the hose over it, put the other end of the hose in a bottle, and as you crack this, you can pump the fluid through the system. Okay, so I'm gonna start by topping off the master cylinder so that we don't accidentally pump air through there. So you take the 10, actually pump the brake, hold it down, crack that open. So once you get that open, you can start pumping. You can see the fluid coming out of the hose into the bottle. As you're pumping, you need to keep an eye on your level, your fluid levels here, and replenish the master cylinder so that you don't suck air into the hose. If you do that, you'll have to do the process for much longer to get the bubbles out. So, as I'm pumping it through, once I see the fluid start coming out clear and new, that tells me that I've replaced the entire lines fluid with new uncooked hydraulic brake fluid. So there we are, it's coming out clear. We'll tighten up the valve, tighten up the bleeder. Remove that. Store the cap. After that, you're gonna want to replenish the master cylinder. You don't want to top it off though, because the little rubber bleeder, little rubber bladder will displace some fluid. Okay, so I have the master cylinder reservoir only filled about halfway because this rubber bladder is going to displace some fluid. Again, pay attention to the shape of the cap, the shape of the master cylinder reservoir, and you know which way to put it on. There you go. Start the bolts by hand as always, so you don't get a little cross thread going. Okay, so once we've got it all snugged up, obviously you take a rag and wipe off the brake fluid that got everywhere, because brake fluid is nasty stuff. Now that everything's tightened up, check the feel. Nice pressure at the lever. Pretty simple actually, probably under a 10 minute job, and something you should think about doing every couple months, or if you're a rear brake dragger, more often than not. But it's a good idea to carry a bottle of brake fluid with you in your vehicle in case you need to do it on a race day. Guys, thanks for watching. Order your Maxima brake fluid at DennisKirk.com, and we'll see you next week.